It's kind of gross, I'm not gonna lie.
Yeah, dead fish, murky water, and swarming vultures. It's not your ideal beach day. Red tide is hitting Marco Island.
Yeah, the stinky sight is disturbing some locals and annoying some visitors. ABC 7's Jennifer Veglas was on the island today. Very smelly New Year's Day. Jennifer.
From afar, it looks like a picture-perfect New Year's Day here at Caxambas Park. But as people are paddling out their kayaks, they're having to get around this mess. A windy start to 2021. Gusts pushing dead tide due to red tide closer to the Marco Island shoreline.
It's obviously not great smelling either.
Stunning the eyes of visitors like Megan Massey.
But I didn't really expect it to be here. Like, I didn't really know if it was during a certain time of the year, how common it was.
And the throats of others.
It's like a burning sensation a little bit. Kind of caused me to cough a little bit as well when you're walking along the beach, collecting shells, whatever you want to do.
Just a few feet away at the park's boat ramp, jet ski and kayak businesses are forced to launch next to floating fish carcasses. Massey says they're small sacrifices to make, all to soak up the Marco Island sun.
It's been really nice weather out, so we've been trying to enjoy the warmth as much as we can.
Meanwhile, in Tiger Tail Lagoon, larger fish kills begin to pile up. Something Audubon Florida says can't be taken lightly.
Everybody has a role to play in this. You know, those nutrients that are fueling red tides come from everything from septic tanks to fertilizer on lawns.
The nonprofit hoping seeing loads of fish carcasses on our beaches will serve as a wake-up call.
It's just so unfortunate to see the sweeping effects on marine life like this.
We also spoke to the Collier County waterkeeper today. They tell us, though these conditions are not ideal, it's still an improvement from the conditions from 2 weeks ago. I'm in Collier County, Jennifer Veglas, ABC 7.